Here it come.
We giving a history lesson out today. Boom, boom.
You ready?
Ready for action. Nip it in the bud, we never relaxing. Outcast is everlasting, not clashing, not at all. But see, my nigga went to do a little acting.
Make sure moves right, Snaps.
Up there goes an orgasm. Now you coming out the side of your face, be tapping right into your memory bank.
Thanks.
So click the ticket, let's see your seatbelt fastened. Trunk rattling like 2 minutes in the back seat rasping. Speaker box vibrate the tag, make it sound like aluminum cans in the bag. Can you feel that beat? But I know y'all want it at 808. Can you feel that beat?
Listen, man, it's going down, man. You see what's going down. You see who we, listen, man.
Hey, listen.
You see who we got in the house, man. Legendary, man. Big boy. You see what I'm saying? Sleepy. They up in here, man. They got a new album, The Big Sleepover. But right now, you're now tuned into me, $1 million worth of game.
Yes, sir.
Absolutely.
Man, listen, man. We got, listen, man, this shit is legendary.
This is
man.
Legendary right here.
This is legend, man, to be around some legends and just, I'm talking about good time. Every time you heard the music, it was a good time, you know. I wasn't at the picnics because I was in jail, but you know, the picnics, the family reunions.
You was at the picnics in the yard. I like doing that.
Whoa. Come on, man. They didn't play in the yard. They didn't have music in the yard.
Ricky Minaj out there like this in the yard. He talking about, I like the way Ricky Minaj. You move.
No, I'm just saying they played it there too, you know. Some nice cuts. They played some cuts in the yard and all that shit, but I stayed calm, you know what I mean? But you wanted to dance and shit, but just like, y'all always made that good feeling music, and then y'all laced it with messages and shit.
Absolutely, man.
It was like, it was so, and then it's still timeless. You still hearing this shit, parties, you know. What was so great the other day, when I seen Steven Jackson got married and Bun B was rapping International Players Anthem.
Oh, that's all.
Oh, nice.
Oh, you ain't see that at the wedding.
Uh-uh.
Oh, man, he just snapped out, grabbed the mic.
Whoa.
I said, damn. Wow. And Steve, shout out to Steve. Congratulations, Steven Jackson. And Bun B just went in. Suit on and everything. He just went in. I'm like, damn. So it was like, you know what I mean? You make this timeless music, this memorable music. And I think that's everything, man. And it's just like, to be ever sitting here with y'all and get some game from y'all, I think that's major for the culture, you know, because, you know, like Sleepy said, man, Sleepy started like Gil and me started, backup dancers. You know what I'm saying? I was a backup dancer for Tupac.
I was a stripper.
We were strippers too, but at the time, that was different.
Sleepy was in that motherfucker.
Like, you know what I mean? Sleepy started as a backup, you know what I mean?
He was battling niggas. He pull your heart out, throw it on the ground and shit.
Yeah. step on it, look at you, pick it back up, throw it at you, all that type of shit. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it was just like, it was life. It was like, it was just a celebration. And you don't see that so much. That's why people can always go back to y'all and just be like, yo, man, it's just this good, feel good music. And it's a celebration, you know. And I still remember the time, you know, when Dre had that Atlanta Braves jersey on at the awards show, and he said, we here.
Yes, sir.
Like, and, you know, this ain't the Atlanta that y'all know now.
We be saying a lot of shit. He, you know, he done did so much shit in life.
I mean,
you know, you remind him of some shit. He like, yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
I fucking forgot about it.
Yeah. Motherfucker toured the world and all that type shit. Yes,
he like, sir. That's when we was just getting some money. Yeah,
but man. It's like, how was it when you and Dre, Big Boy, first came into the game, coming from Atlanta? And you know, this was a New York driven game. This was New York and California driven.
Yeah.
How hard was it?
You seen we got booed, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Even though we won, and Sleepy Bean with Organized Noise, I mean, they trained us to be lyricists, you know what I'm saying?
Like, shout out to Rico Wade, Organized Noise, the whole Dungeon Ray Murray.
And so, you know, it was kind of like heartbroke a little bit, but at the same time, like, we was built for it. And so what it did was just put a charge in our back. You know, because we wanted to demand our respect. And, you know, right now we were 16, 17 years old. And now, you know, almost 30 years later, still just having fun, man, living life.
Yeah, how do you feel to see how what y'all done started, man? Like the energy, you know, looking at the energy in the city of Atlanta now, how Atlanta just like
on fire.
They on fucking fire. You seeing these young cats, man, that was babies. You know, their moms and their dads listen to your music, but right. they was babies and they just controlling shit out here.
Shit hard as hell, man. It's like, you know, shout out to, you know, Future, he Dungeon Family too. That's yes. next okay. generation of people that came out the dungeon. And all the other youngsters out here just doing their thing. One thing I say about Atlanta is how we can stay on top like that is the camaraderie. You know what I'm saying? Everybody mm-hmm. work with everybody. Everybody fuck with everybody. Because you're going to bump into somebody at so-and-so strip club or so-and-so studio. So, I mean, you ain't got time to be beefing like that. You know what I mean?
Right.
For sure.
But one thing I could say is, man, I just want to give y'all flowers. Because every artist that we interview from Atlanta, and we say, you know, tell us your top five Atlanta artists of all time. Y'all always first.
Hey, yeah, that's what.
And that's coming from the youngins. You yeah, feel man. What I'm saying? That's coming from the owners of tomorrow.
Yeah,
you know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? And for them to recognize that, no, they was the ones who opened the door for us. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah. Y'all led that wave of some shit that y'all didn't even know was gonna be taken. Control of the music industry for 20 plus fucking years, bro.
Yeah, it's a blessing, man. It's definitely a blessing.
Because all the way from the 70s, the 80s, the 90s, New York had that shit.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And then here come these little motherfuckers from out of Atlanta.
Yeah.
For sure, man.
And changed the whole direction of that shit.
All
man.
The players.
And you know, shout out to Jermaine Dupri. It was a few yeah, motherfuckers yeah, yeah. that was yes, sir, yes, coming out, you know.
Babyface L.A. Reid, you right. had them, yes, you know sir. What I mean?
Thank God for L.A. Reid coming yes. to Atlanta, man.
Yes.
Gave us jobs, bro.
L.A. Reid, shout out to L.A. Reid. Shout out to L.A. Reid. You know, they gave niggas jobs, man.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. And that's what's most important. One thing I noticed about Atlanta, too, you know, artists could be beef and they could be going through it and then they pop up on a record together.
Oh, yeah. You know what's crazy though? LaFace Records don't be getting mentioned when they be talking about these black labels. I know, and never, you, I never hear nobody talking about LaFace. Like, I don't even think, I think it got so big that people didn't even understand who LaFace Records was.
I think it might be because when the LA sold that bitch for about $100 million,
yeah.
cashed out.
Yeah.
they might have forgot. They might have forgot. You know what I'm saying?
He forgot about that motherfucker.
What you say? He forgot. Sorry. He forgot about that. Do you bring that shit up? What's that?
Nobody mentioned the face when they talk about
oh,
black
yeah, hair. I do remember what I used to own that shit, yeah, man. Yeah, the yeah. Before they socked it to my pocket.
They had some monsters on that motherfucker. You know what I mean?
Yeah, $100 million make you forget a bunch of shit.
Yeah, TLC, Tony Braxton, Usher. Us, Tony Rich.
Yep.
Shit, Destiny's
People
Child.
People forget about Tony Rich Project. Him. Nobody knows but, it but me.
But he was went my diamond guy. With that shit.
He, yeah. went, diamond. Yeah. he went diamond with that song?
He went diamond yeah. with that album. Yeah, he went diamond. Yes,
damn.
God damn.
Oh, why you ain't seen? Gone. Cash
that motherfucker
out.
Got that money. You ain't never seen Tony Rich.
Well, gone. Because Tony's rich.
Damn. Tony said, why the fuck would I double back? He's only down from here.
Yeah. Fuck.
Fuck is going on?
Tony Rich. Tony, that's name. You got to put rich in your name. You might get rich.
Man, but, hey. Shit. He did it, man.
God damn. Yeah,
right.
So, went diamond.
First record, bro. Went diamond. Crazy.
Yeah, he's only down from there. I'm just, that's the reality. Ask 50 Cent. No, bro, that's not no shit. That's not like nobody. Once you hit a certain level of success, it's like how many people go diamond and then go diamond again? Yeah, right. Ask Nelly.
She asked me.
Yeah, shit. See?
We went diamond. We diamond and a half. Crew control right,
right.
now.
Did you go diamond again?
Shit, I got diamonds.
That's a local hey, so do 50 Cent. So do Nelly. Right. 50 out here going diamond on the fucking TV screen now.
Gotta go to something else.
Yeah. So at the end of the day, it's not no slight to 50 or Nelly or none of that. It's just that when you reach a certain level of fucking success, it's hard to get there again. Like you may get 2 times platinum, 3 times, 4 times. 10 times?
Yeah, that's what you got to reinvent yourself,
and then
man.
We grew up in a different era. Right. We grew up in an era where that meant 10 million
went
people
to the store and bought
went
it.
To the fucking store absolutely, and purchased absolutely. A CD or a fucking tape, man.
Right, right. Yeah, I absolutely. Mean, right now the game is rigged.
You made 10 million niggas get up and go to that. Just think about how fucking great that shit is.
Absolutely. Yeah.
You said the game is...
It's rigging me because they got these, what, them streaming farms or something? Like, I just found out about that. I was like, hold on.
Streaming farms fucked you up,
what
didn't
the
it?
Fuck? That shit crazy.
Oh, I ain't know about that.
It's yeah, man. But about goddamn thousands of phones in the warehouse and this number just...
Yeah. Making you running your numbers up. No, this shit was so organic. You had to go stand in line. You had to go get your CD. You had to walk up to the line. They had to scan your shit. Boom.
Yep.
Wait, hold on. My scanner ain't working. Wait. Boom. Oh, there we go. These motherfuckers were selling CDs for $12.99.
Yeah.
Fuck that. Motherfuckers' albums now going for $6.
Yeah.
42 songs, $6.
Yeah. 42
songs. 42 songs, $6.
Motherfuckers didn't want to give you more than 12. They like, we don't get paid after 12 songs.
Right. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
It was a different game.
I get them niggas 16 just because we artists and we got some shit that got to go on there.
Yeah, exactly.
But,
you know, right.
It's like, so it, this it. Shit, you know, when you looking at these OGs, because a lot of y'all young niggas take the mentality, you old ass niggas, them niggas.
Yeah.
You supposed to be trying to get old.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
You supposed to be trying to live to see our age. None of us up here is not mad that we didn't do some dumb shit and get shot in the head at 22 and go to heaven. We like to see our kids go to school, grow the fuck up.
Yeah.
Motherfucking take your kids to kindergarten, then to eighth grade, then to high school, watch them go on to prime.
Recitals.
Right. Yeah. You feel what I'm saying? So all the young niggas out there, respect the OGs and understand that one day, if you lucky, you'll be OG.
Yeah, but you make sure you preserve your face so you can still, you know what I'm talking about?
Okay.
Yeah, make sure you still got that.
Absolutely. Before we go any further, this episode of Million Dollars Worth of Game is brought to you by New Amsterdam Vodka. Now let me tell you something about New Amsterdam Vodka, right? It's distilled 5 times, it's filtered 3 times for a clean, crisp finish.
Ooh,
you know, it was born in the heartlands of America, too. So you drink it straight up, you can drink it on the rocks, you can make the classic New Amsterdam Mule. And one thing about New Amsterdam Vodka, life ain't going your way. Shout out New Amsterdam Vodka. Caught your bitch cheating today.
Shout out New Amsterdam Vodka.
Yes, sir.
Y'all had to change this shit to a $1 gazillion worth of game. Because y'all got it all, man.
I mean, you know, there's something about this New Amsterdam vodka. There's the purity in it.
Yes.
But no, they blood, boy. Y'all boys have the chemistry over there, boy. But bounce that energy back and forth,
boy.
Yeah, for sure.
But when you're out and about at your local liquor store, make sure you pick up some New Amsterdam vodka. It's great for pregame. And, you know, you got the playoffs right now. I mean, the playoffs coming up. You got the basketball season. So when you're out and about at your local liquor store, get some New Amsterdam vodka. Now, I want to ask you a question. When y'all first came out, y'all straight, looking like some straight hood little niggas coming up out of Atlanta. Y'all got the jerseys on.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? At what point did Dre make the transition? Like, and it's a two question. And how did the transition come? Was he talking about it? Like, was he like, yo, man, I'm thinking about, you know, switching my shit up a little bit? Or did one day he just show up at the studio with some motherfucking shoulder pads on, like, throw the beat on?
It was a little bit of both. It was like, first it was like, man, we need to look like the music. You know what I'm saying? Southern Playlistic, we was 17.
Player
still.
Shit.
Yeah, it was just some players just still. We was at the dungeon smoking, drinking. Whoop, got on. Traveled a little bit, saw a little bit more. And then we went into ATL. And so, you know, that's out of this world. So, I mean, he was just like, man, we need to start looking like the music, like Parliament Funkadelic, how they look like the funk. You know what I'm saying? And it was a time, I guess he really, Aquemini.
Yeah.
That was what shocked me when I showed up. Got gaiters and shit all in my bag and got, you know, all my fur and stuff. And the Dre came, but he had some straw pants, like Scarecrow.
Yeah.
Now, like, word?
Right. All right, hold on. So was you acceptive to it from the beginning or you had to warm up to it? Like,
no, I warmed up. I was like, that shit fire. Because when we took the picture together, the contrast was like, oh, shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, that's what it was, the yin and the yang.
Yeah.
And then from there, we would just get outfits tailor-made and we would have the same colors on. Like we, yeah. had, we was thinking about the same colors, but never
your shit
talk
was
about.
More.
It was like I was straight Gullah Geechee.
Yeah,
you know what
yeah.
I'm talking about for
yeah.
real.
Yeah.
And then Dre was just like, "Shit, experiment with it." And it was yeah. just from there, just whatever.
But Dre always kind of remind me of George in a way. You know what I'm saying? Like
George
first,
Clinton.
Yeah, when I first saw it,
talking to the mic, sleep.
Oh my God! When I first saw it for myself, we were doing a Skewered on a Barbie video, and man, we were all at Tabernacle, which was kind of like the House of Blues. Everybody's backstage, and it's all crowded in the hallway. The next thing you know, the door opened up, man. Dre come out. He got on the white furry like bracelets, with white shorts.
Monkey pants.
Monkey pants, monkey shorts with the ski boots and the white wig. And everybody just stopped talking for like 2 minutes and just got quiet as fuck. Everybody just stared at him. And then he walked in the other room and everybody started talking again. You know what I mean? So when I went to him, I said, Dre, like, how you feel about this? Like, you know what I'm saying? Are you nervous? He's like, bruh, they're either going to do two things. They're going to either laugh at me or be with me. Yeah. So by him saying that, I knew he had the confidence to just say, fuck, let's do it. You know what I mean?
From the jump, yeah, I know what time it was.
Yeah.
But I tell you who was surprised, that motherfucking Raekwon. He was like, man, what y'all nigga doing, man? I thought we were shooting a video. He was like, we in. You know what I mean? And we shot the video, and Raekwon was like, all right, I fuck with it.
And what video was that?
Skewed on the barbecue. Yep. Yeah.
Old school players, the new school food.
Yep.
Cats keep it jumping.
That was the shit.
And Kavroot. Yeah. That was the shit, yeah.
That's right. They gonna change the rules.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. That was the shit.
This episode of $1 Million Worth of Game is brought to you by Manscaped. Right now, you get 20% off and free shipping when you go to manscaped.com/million. Listen, man, I'm talking about them stocking stuffers. Mm. You know you need things. I'm talking about you want to get some the Shear 2.0 luxury four-piece nail clips, the crop mic, the crop mop, what is the, you know, the ball wipes for them stinky balls. You get the signature, the Manscaped Signature Cologne infused with body wash. You get the Manscaped 2-in-1 shampoo and conditioner. Just launch, you know, that shit just launched. You kill two birds in one stone. Right now, I'm talking about, you got the lawnmower. You always got the lawnmower. You want to clean yourself. You want to make sure you're cleaning you right down there. So when you're dealing with it, she's like, oh, he's nice. He's clean. He's smooth. He's cool. That's what Manscaped do for you. I'm talking about, well, right now, what you need to do is you need to go to manscaped.com. You're getting free shipping, and you're getting 20% off when you go to manscaped.com/million. Like, what are you waiting for?
Can I say something?
Go ahead.
Your balls will thank you later.
Your balls definitely will thank you later.
You right know, your now, balls will look up to you like, thanks.
Yeah.
Go to so the, smooth down there.
Yes, go to the site
finally
right now.
Trim me up.
And take and get some of these wild gifts. I'm some of these great gifts. Stocking stuffers. Manscaped.com/million.
So now, shit's changing up a little bit. Dre showing up. Shit a little different. Do you think that helped y'all as far as record sales? As far as growth? As far as...
Going because, to the next
because,
level.
Because when you... When you start doing shit like, hey, and you, that's a whole different demographic.
Yeah. Absolutely. I mean, it's really the true embodiment of us just being real rock stars. You know what I'm saying? Right. Black rockers, like, you know. The music sounded like how we looked. You know what I'm saying? And so we would just match the music. So the plan was ingenious. We was like, man, let's look like the music.
Right.
And we just did. We just kept it going, man.
You know what, Cass, if I can say this, Cass was like the only rap group that I ever seen that did all genres of music. They did country with Rosa Parks. That was a country beat, bro.
Right.
They had a breakdown with the rap. You know what I'm saying? You listen to, that's a country record. They did rock. They've done every genre of music with hip hop, which is insane.
That's major. Now, when y'all when the transition started, because you went from Southern Player listed Cadillac Music, and then y'all start fucking the charts up and Grammy. How was it on the financial end with the record labels and all that? Did y'all ever had a bad situation?
Nope. I'm going to tell you why. Because of this guy right here and Rico and Ray from Organized Noise. We were signed to LaFace, Organized Noise, was a production deal. So they let us keep our publishing. They didn't take our publishing. We kept our own publishing. They kept all of it to us. So after we did ATLians, they again... let us loose and let us sign straight to LaFace. So they just cut out the whole middle part and was like, we're going to let y'all boys do y'all. And we own our masters, all our publishing and everything because they didn't try to fuck us off.
Ho. You went diamond in the half and y'all own all that shit right now?
Yeah.
God damn.
Yeah. Fucking fuck you think Dre running around the world playing a motherfucking cello for? I don't even want to talk to you niggas.
He said a cello.
A cello.
What he playing?
The flute.
The flute. Oh, he running around like this. Yeah. I don't even want to talk to niggas no more. I got my masters. We want diamond. Dre put another album out.
Oh my God.
Dre, we got a movie role for you. You niggas didn't know we got our masters. We were fucking diamond. Yo, Dre in New Mexico. He in Bolivia.
That's crazy, man. He in Philly.
He was in Philly. Coming that's how I know. Because motherfuckers went around talking about, yo, Andre 3000 downtown playing the flute. Niggas like, yep. Shut the fuck up, man.
Yeah, man.
No, he walking around downtown playing. Dog, shut the fuck up, bro.
Yeah, nah,
Andre 3000, what the fuck would he be doing downtown playing the flute for no fucking reason at all?
Shoot
and then I seen him, I was like, oh, that nigga's all the way at peace.
Yeah, he's
definitely
that's when you. That's when you seen so much. I can't wait till I get that much fucking money.
That's some real money.
You know, I can't wait till I get me some money. Real money. It's some real money. Peace. It's some real. You know, money bring you peace. Yeah, but you get away from every fucking body. You get me out of that. I don't want to talk to you niggas. they be like, we see Gilly A. We're quiet as shit smoking weed. You know, we had our masters.
Yeah.
For real. Yeah, man, because you got to understand, and I joke and I play around, but we black people that come from nothing, bro.
Yeah.
Yep.
Nothing. Nothing. So to even be able to sit here and joke about him being so rich and being at peace, that's just a salute to y'all for the work y'all put in.
Absolutely.
You feel what I'm saying? Because y'all didn't get to that having what y'all got by being lazy, being, you know, procrastinating or none of that shit. Y'all got there because y'all niggas is talented and y'all niggas put the work in.
Yeah,
man. Because it's a lot of talented niggas out here that ain't gonna never have half the shit y'all got because they not gonna put half the work you niggas put in.
Yeah.
So when I play and I joke and I want the youngins out there to see the bigger picture of the joke. Is that he put enough work in that if he want to go from city to city, country to country, motherfucking state to state, small town to small town, and just play the motherfucking flute for the rest of his life, I can do that.
That's right.
Absolutely.
Because that's how much motherfucking work I put in the first half of my life.
Yes.
Exactly. That's real.
So I can take from 44 to 45 to however old I am to my expiration date. If I just want to run around and play the motherfucking flute,
right.
I can do that. And that's what it's about. It's about putting in, doing what you don't want to do now so you could do what the fuck you want to do later.
Yeah, yeah.
You feel me? I see you got the dogs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Tell us a little bit. I got a Frenchie and shit. You know what I mean? I love my little dog, Million.
Yeah, man. Nah, you know, we first started out, me and my little brother, breeding pit bull terriers. And then, you know, the business mind of me in the early Outkast albums, we would advertise in the booklet. Mm-hmm. And it's been like 25 years. We switched over to Frenchies. But what I did, I went from being a backyard breeder when I bought my first house to my second crib. I had like a mini setup, and then I ended up buying like 40-something acres, and now we got a ranch out by Six Flags where, you know, my brother got like a little $500,000 house out there, indoor, outdoor runs for the dogs. And, yeah, he thriving, man. He feed his family off of it.
Mm. I mean, dogs he got.
Wait. We're not going to get past that light flex right there.
40 acres.
We got a little 40 acres, you know, having me a house for the dogs.
The dogs.
No. My fucking dogs living better than me. God damn. Throw me on the 40.
That's crazy.
Yeah, man.
But that's what's up, man. I see you really look like you and be enjoying that shit, too.
Oh, yeah. No,
he
definitely.
Love that shit.
How many dogs you got?
We got about 50-something dogs over there now.
How many dogs you personally got?
Oh, I got two Rottweilers that live in my house with me.
You feed them gunpowder just to devour when the criminals try to drop a dozen.
I actually feed as boiled chicken.
Yeah. Boiled chicken?
Boiled chicken. A dog would fuck that up. Boiled chicken.
You season it and all that shit?
I might put some chicken bouillon in there, but just boiled chicken and rice. And I feed it to them and make the coat shiny, and they just protect the house. You know what I'm saying? Well, niggas just can't come up and just throw no peace over the fence.
Yeah, ain't none of
Okay,
but he trying to get some fucking money, man.
Yeah, he talking about bull cheese.
I just want to apologize to my dog, man. A million.
No, don't feed that much. This dog.
You know what I mean, I'm feeding your dog food. Shit, my fault. I thought dogs were supposed to eat dog food.
He get the most expensive dog food. Think he doing something?
This fucking dog. I ain't doing shit.
But listen, big boy, I need to know something. This fucking dog, something is wrong with it. Because I never seen a Frenchie this hyperactive. This motherfucker be trying to jump over walls and jump over me. Why is he so hyped? Why is she so hyped?
They do that, though. My daughter got one, too, named Billy, and she just energized like that. I don't know because it's just so compact or if it's the food, but they're super hyper. Super.
Oh, okay, because
I thought something was wrong.
Yeah, I started thinking something was wrong. My mom,
motherfucker be
looking at pit bulls. I'm like, nigga, this is a loss.
They like that, man.
For both of us. Fucking shit. I'm going to have to let you fucking go so I get away, nigga. Chill out. So, y'all got the album coming out?
Yes, sir. December 10th, tomorrow. Tonight. Comes out tonight. Yes, Big
Sleepo. Who's on there?
We got Killer Mike on the album a couple of times, like three times. We got CeeLo Green on the album. Underground artist Scotty ATL from Atlanta. Yes, for sure. Production by Organized Noise, uh-huh. Calvo the Great, Point Guard from 1500 to Nothing.
Yes, sir.
1500 to Nothing.
14 tracks, top to bottom, same thing.
How did it feel going in there, man? Did it feel like yesterday?
It's every day for us. You know what I'm saying? If we ain't on the road and we in the yo cooking or just putting down ideas. And that's how you can stay sharp and compete at a high level with yourself. You know what I'm saying? So, we're just keeping it going, man. This motherfucker's a monster.
Did Dre hear the album?
I played him some songs, yeah.
He was like, I was shocked when Dre popped up on Kanye shit out of nowhere.
Yeah,
I was
talking
like,
about that. Yeah.
Was like, wow.
Yeah.
Like, when you go see him and you playing them albums, is you like playing him some records, you be like, you ain't ready yet, nigga.
Nah, he'd just be like,
We could do some beats with the flute, nigga.
I play it. He'd be like, well, y'all nigga rapping. Like, really?
Yeah, coming from you.
So then, I did get some flute, though. Get some flute when we was doing the song with CeeLo Intentions. I got about 10 minutes worth of flute.
Yeah. That ain't bad.
Just holding it.
You got to tell Dre whatever you got to tell him. Get him, nigga. We do the whole album off the flute. Let's fucking get it. This the flute album, nigga. That's the name of the album, the flute.
That bitch will go too.
The bitch will go. What?
Yeah, won't it?
It will.
What? Cause y'all some creative motherfuckers. Y'all could do anything out here.
That should be crazy. Now, what is your favorite Outkast song?
It's like trying to pick your kids and say one of the favorite. I could say from time to time, I love Bombs Over Baghdad.
That shit was heavy. Unless you
performance realm, that shit is a must. Yeah, anytime, a anywhere you go, crazy.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Y'all, all right, so when the last time y'all did a show?
We did the Outkast 20 tour. That was about, 4 or 5 years ago?
Yep.
The Atlas, that's when we headlined Coachella. Mm-hmm. And then we did like 3 sold-out shows at Centennial Park and went all to Europe and everything. We had a good time.
That was a long tour.
Yeah, but we had some fun on that motherfucker. Yeah.
We got to see y'all back
on tour, man. When can you think we could see y'all? Hopefully.
Just gotta talk to the Lord, man. Like, talk to the Lord. Just never know.
Never know,
man. Like you said,
God,
man.
Please.
We just
let them come back for one more tour.
We just really just living, man. You know, when you start so young, you know, me and Dre hooked up in 10th grade. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then, like you said, all the work we put in, you want to enjoy the fruits of your labor.
Yeah, we worked the hell out of them, man.
But sometimes y'all just don't miss that.
Yeah, man, that and just.
I know now you on a deal. 52 dogs. Come here, Rocco. It's a little noise, a little different. Yeah. You know, you enjoy it. Y'all dig. Got them Gucci flip flops on. You know,
all that shit.
No shirt. Can't nobody see you. You know, 40 acres. You
all
know
that shit.
But sometimes you don't be. Because it's not like. It's a difference when you an artist and the roar is over. Because when the roar is over, you miss it more.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Because it's not there. And you know it's not there in your mind. Like, But the roar never leaves for y'all. Like, right. The roar's always there.
Yeah. That's why I stay on the road, man. I love it. That's one reason why we still making albums and doing new shit is because we stay on the road. That's my favorite
part. How often
part
are you on the road out of the year?
We might do about what? 7,500 shows maybe? Yeah.
You said how many shows?
75 or 100.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, I mean, 75 or 100.
I thought he said 7,500.
I thought he said 7,500.
Oh, hell
I
no.
Said, hey, damn.
No. 75 or 100.
I just said, fuck that. I'm carrying a bag.
No, I get to pick it.
The niggas that carry the bags make $1 million.
Yeah.
7,500.
I get to pick and choose like what I want to do. You know what I mean?
Of course.
So, yeah. I mean, a lot of festivals, a lot of corporate bags is like
the corporate bags is unbelievable.
Oh, I just say, hey man, I don't know.
Them
I got,
corporate events.
I got the combination to the bag route. Me and Killer Mike, yeah, we got it, and Brown too.
Killer Mike, corporate game.
Well, let me
crazy.
Just say something. Well, get just slide us a little paper with the combination on it. We could unlock this
shit.
Damn,
come on, y'all doing it?
That corporate motherfucker money.
Y'all
we got 7 or 5 shoes, not 75.
You talking about 7 or 5?
7 to 10. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
that
would be everywhere though, man.
500. But no, I think a lot of people, and I know y'all could talk on this. I think a lot of artists never even tap into that corporate money.
Yeah, it's called protecting your brand.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
And educate these artists on the importance of their approach and how they approach could deal with the lifetime of their career.
Yeah, man, you just gotta keep all your options open, and you know you gotta keep your name clean. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like a lot of the foolishness, like you don't know, like people will drop you for doing some dumb shit. Yeah. So then that shit will trickle down. But if your name clean and you do good business, man, they're gonna call you back every time.
So artists, when he say your name clean, he tell me something. You gotta be mindful when you're on your page and you posting guns.
They look at all that shit.
You're saying certain shit because they might be wanting to do a brand deal with you. It might be a big sneaker brand. It might be an automobile corporation. And they be like, they're going to have a person that's going to go and check your whole profile, right. Check your whole thing out. They're going to Google your life.
Yes.
And they're going to say, oh, no, this person's not for us. And they might be having a real bag for you.
Right.
Yeah. Like them bags, this ain't no small, this real fucking money.
Yeah. Yeah. But you on your page with a chopper. Nike wanna do a deal with you, but you on your page with Chuck. Guess what Nike ain't coming out with? The Nike AK edition.
AK 47 edition.
They ain't coming out with the AK 47 edition with the chopper on the side.
Yeah.
For the shooters.
Right.
I'm just so a lot of times. Right. A lot of times and I understand because I was young. When you're young and you coming up, you proving yourself. Yeah, no, I'm the big lion. I got the biggest roar. But a lot of times, in the midst of proving yourself, you be destroying yourself.
Yeah.
Because you're proving and you're proving, but you're moving farther and farther away from the corporate money, from the corporate business, from the corporate people. The people that really matter, the people that's going to change your life, the people that's going to have you buying $500,000 houses for the dogs.
Because the thing about a corporate thing,
hey,
you see what I'm saying?
You know what's funny when you ask Steve, a lot of artists be slipping out here. He said,
he know.
I knew I was thinking what he was taking more money for me. because the reality of it is this. All these corporations got the list. Who we want to fuck with for this one?
The masterpiece.
We putting out 1,000 new LA Fitnesses. Okay, I like the way you move. Yeah. Okay, let's get them real quick for the commercials.
Commercial.
Yeah.
We want to play their music and just, we don't even want them to perform. We just want them to be walking on the treadmill in the joint and just walk by them.
Yeah.
Here go $1 million. Like I'm talking about something like artists, y'all don't understand. Like you might be getting $75,000 to show. These people come and pay you for 10, 15 minutes and give you $750,000.
Facts.
It's a different game. If you bring the value to they got a different budget. This ain't no promoter. This ain't no janky promoter.
No, they damn sure do.
That's trying to shuffle your money up at the end of the show.
Yeah.
In a club somewhere on a chitlin shirt. This ain't one of them things. This somebody that's going cut that check. It ain't gonna play no games. It's going that wire gonna hit your account. It ain't no. And you gonna be like, I just did that shit for like an hour. Just sit there, and I only really did 15 minutes.
Then what they're going to do at the Christmas party, say if you're dealing with Peloton people are going to see the people at, say, Realtor.com and be like, it was so fun working with Big Boy. They're like, huh, what do you do? Like, you should work with him. Boom. Hey, we got another bag for you. Boom.
Yeah.
Just trickle just like that.
And they always tell people about when you do good business. That's why you got to first, if you first do good business, you'll get opportunities to do good business on the next level with corporate America, and they're going to tell everybody about how you do good business. But the business start from your Instagram page.
Yeah, be careful.
Be careful and be mindful, you know, and I know you, I know it'd be the moment, and I know you want to prove that you a real nigga and all that shit. That real nigga shit ain't going to have you taking care of your family way after your record is dead.
I'm telling you another thing too. I realize, like a lot of the youngsters too, if you're gonna do dope or get high, or get drunk, put the phone down. Don't go to your phone when you're in your right state of mind.
Yeah.
And then this is $1 million worth of game. I wanted to come up with an app that you, if you know you're gonna be drinking, you could turn something on and it'll fake post for you. You'll think you posted that shit.
Yeah, that's smart.
And it should have just been C Circle TM trademark. Don't take my shit.
Don't take your shit. Yeah,
but
yeah.
Like, you know. You would think it's going out, but it won't post. But you be in your right mind next day, you wake up, you be like, oh, boy, it didn't go through. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Put that phone down, man, when you do that.
Yeah.
This episode of $1 million Worth of Game is brought to you by Amazon Music.
Amazon Music.
Since you like listening to shows, because that's pretty obvious because you're listening to this one, Amazon provides unlimited podcasts. I'm talking about Amazon Music has more than 10 million free podcast episodes to listen to. But Amazon Music isn't just for listening to podcasts. They have thousands of music stations and top playlists to stream for free. You hear me? For free. And no matter what you're listening to, you can go hands-free with Alexa. If you're like me and you love music on demand, they got over 75 million songs, as well as podcasts, music videos, and more with Amazon Music Unlimited. You can listen to any song anywhere, anytime, offline with unlimited skips. So if you never tried Amazon Music Unlimited, now is a great time for unlimited time. New customers can get Amazon Music Unlimited for free for 3 months. You hear that? For free for 3 months. That's Amazon.com/dollars, D-O-L-L-A-Z, to try Amazon Music Unlimited for free for 3 months. Go get that. Like, we don't turn down nothing for free. Amazon Music /dollars, right?
That's real game from an OG. That's $1 billion worth of game, because what happened is we living in this world, big boy. We living in this world where it's though. We got to show people everything. Like privacy is the new, for real, privacy is worth more than money. Privacy is everything, bro.
Yeah.
But it's like we don't even respect that shit no more. We got to show everything. I got to show you, that I'm at a red light. I gotta show you that I'm at the next red light. I gotta show you when I pull in the parking lot of CVS. I gotta show you. You see, I said CVS, so we, you know,
hook me up.
Hook me up, CVS. I gotta show you. I go to CVS. I gotta show you that I'm in the aisle buying some Johnson & Johnson lotion. Johnson & Johnson. Hook me up. Once I get the lotion.
I'm saying hook you the fuck up. It's we the
guys. I got you. I got you.
So you doing single please in front of me and shit. Like, hook me up.
He don't even dig it. I'm trying to listen.
The fuck is you talking about? Like, I ain't here, nigga.
Johnson & Johnson, he used Jergens. Jergens. Holla at him. It's a different, you know, it's different bags. But damn, cuz.
What was you using in jail?
I don't use lotion. How about that?
Damn, you was just going raw like that. You was in there jerking off raw hand.
Nah, I don't need you know baby oil, nigga.
This nigga was but, baby oil.
But whatever it might be. See, Sleepy ain't shit. Sleepy, he was some bullshit.
Johnny, put this baby oil on me.
Get the fuck out of here. I ain't say no shit like that.
You just ain't say no shit like that.
So at the end of the day, it's like this, though. You know, we live in a world where you got to show everything. Because everything is visual, and it's about if you ain't show it, you ain't live it. And we take this social media, and it's like I keep telling people, it's like everybody's life is like a Netflix special. Mm. So you got people that subscribe and following your page to see your fucking life.
Right.
Oh, damn, that's how he make his tuna fish. I ain't know he put honey in onions and peppers and whatever in his tuna fish. Like, they want to see everything. There's no privacy no more.
Yeah.
The phone even watch you. You got the phone. You think you going texting. Phone looking at you, man.
Yeah,
you somewhere in the office on a big screen. They watching you.
Yeah, for real.
Like so everything is being monitored. So it's like, if you got some privacy, if you, man. Because like one of my things for the new year, I say, man, I'm putting my phone down more. You see what I'm saying? Just in life in general, like not being on social and just getting back to just the human connection, just walking down the street, kicking it with somebody, going into a restaurant, just kicking it with somebody that I don't know and just starting regular conversation. You know what I mean? Because we don't do that shit no more. It's like, it ain't even cool.
You could go to the restaurant with some people you know. You know how to... That's some weirdo shit. I'm just going to go to restaurants and just start talking to people I don't know. So how you doing?
No, you know I'll be downtown and shit, different places, different like, cities.
Walking into places. You look like the center city stalker and shit. You will be all over. It's a man that just keeps going into restaurants talking to people. If you see him, this is a picture of him. If you see him, notify the police immediately.
I don't think they'd do that.
No, I feel you, though, because my problem is, I told myself, I was
talking to Mike,
waking up. I'm gonna stop waking up, and first thing is pick up my phone. That's what I need to stop doing. You know what I mean? You turn over, you pick up.
You can't, because that shit the news.
Then you start going through.
It's the news.
Yeah.
Because the mic.
Because you pick your phone up.
I'm sorry. Yeah.
Yeah. You pick your phone up. Nigga only been in music industry for 42 years.
he might be looking for one of them emails. He might be looking for a bank notification.
He like a nigga on stage like this.
Use the mic, nigga.
Yeah.
Oh my god, my fault, man.
Y'all know we silly as shit, man. I was saying.
Sleepy might be getting up looking for that bank notification, the wire from publishing check or something.
Oh no, I do that too, yeah.
I do that too, yes. Yes. But at the end of the day, when you wake up and you go to that Instagram, you find out everything.
Everything you missed since you've been
sleeping.
Everything
you missed. That shit pop right up on you and you like, damn. Right, yeah. Like, so.
You got your mood for the whole day.
Because
it sets your mood for the whole day. You have to watch it
going
on Instagram, because the first thing you read could be something that happened to a black person in another city. You pissed off already.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So you have to really
be careful. It'll fuck your mood up. It dictates your mood up.
Instagram is a mood director.
Yeah, absolutely.
I like that mood director. I'm going to use that in a video. Yeah, but no, like, it do. You will see it, and now you're
they stealing my shit.
I knew you for the
because you ain't say trademark, like, what's the name did? So I can steal
trademark my shit, mood director, right now, though.
See, Circle TM.
Circle TM. Yeah.
Man,
fuck you niggas up. You.
But all right, whatever the case may be, it's like, you right. You will look at that shit, and that alter your energy and your approach. You might be looking at that, and then you might get it. Listen, you're looking at that. You're looking at some texts from some family members or somebody asking for something.
Yeah, absolutely.
How is it? Listen. How is it when you get successful with the relationships, the family members, and you know, everybody always, is it, did y'all, I know I'm pretty sure y'all experienced how once y'all start seeing money, everybody had a financial problem that know you?
Yeah.
It happens. It
how do you happen. Deal with that?
You treat it like a FICO score. Like everybody get one or two, rent late or the car broke down, can you help me out? I got a big family, so everybody can get one or two of those, but then at the end of the day, just only responsible for my mom, you know what I mean? Like my mom and my kids. So everybody else grown. Like I retired my mom like 20 years ago. Like, I had to work, boom, boom, put on the payroll. She just living right now, so. That should be the goal, you know what I mean? But everybody can help everybody in the family, but my grandmom told me something. You got to learn how to say no. You do.
And let me just tell you something. That's always been a cornerstone of black families, the grandmothers. They always gave up the real game, because you know why? They came from the real hardest fucking times. Right. They was running around. They was out here, motherfuckers getting hosed down the street, rolling and shit. So they came from the real hard times.
Yeah,
so they,
They
always gave
the raw shit.
Right. Now your grandma be motherfucking 38. Shit, she ain't.
She had motherfucking Magic City. She still working Magic City.
You go Instagram now, grandma got her hands on her knees, popping and shit, twerking and shit.
Oh, fuck,
man. You know what I mean? Shout out to rest in peace of my grandma Rose and my grandma. I mean, I ain't never seen them dance.
Right.
You know what I mean? Now you see your grandma posting up OnlyFans and shit.
She got
the
time
to me OnlyFans.
She rolling some motherfucker.
Grandma got a hooker.
She rolling some OG Kush.
And it always seemed like grandmoms back in the day was old.
Yeah.
Right.
Like your grandmom was 60 when you was a fucking kid or something. 50 when you was like no. Your grandmom now, you be 39, and your grandmom be 42, and a motherfucking child be 16.
Yeah. Yeah, that is.
How the fuck that happened?
My son started fucking early too, yeah. I got a grandbaby.
Yeah, I know. Damn. Me too. Yeah,
I got grandbaby too.
Yeah, I'm fucking grandfam, and I just had to warm up to him because I told the nigga, don't make me no motherfucking young ass grandparents, nigga.
I wanted to be young with him because I ain't want my grandkid to be like, man, fuck your granddaddy, and I can't catch him. You know what I'm saying?
So now you got it.
Yeah.
I actually told my son the first 5 years, you know, I don't know the little nigga. When he turned five, I'm gonna take him in. Way like he brand new. Because I told you, nigga, don't have no kids. Kids, I wasn't ready for that shit. Fuck, I put an album out. I'm fucking pop.
No.
I might still want to put an album out. I'm fucking pop. Put an album out.
We pop.
No, he already got a fan base.
I'm Poppy's son, man.
He already got a $1 trillion fan base out here. He can do what the fuck he wants.
He ain't worried about
this level yet. I'm still trying to break through. Old nigga trying to break through. Pop trying to break through. Pop with his breakthrough album.
It's a beautiful thing, man. Like, for sure. Like, I my mom told me, he's like, it's no type of love like that.
Yeah, it's a different thing. It is, for sure.
Real talk, I love my grandson, man, and my nephews and my nieces, man.
Yes, sir.
I'm a children's type of, you know, guy. I like to have the kids over to my house. Yep. I play with them all day, laugh and joke, and that's just who I am.
Yeah, I got a gang of nieces and nephews, too.
Damn,
everybody kind of Uncle Twan, how? Come on.
Twan, they be over there deep.
Oh, you Twan?
Antoine.
Twine over there watching all the kids.
Yeah.
Everybody drop him off at Twine crib. You know he gonna be in there playing with the dogs. You ain't gotta worry about him leaving there for 3-4 days.
Every time I go over there, it'll be family. You know,
leave him there for 3-4 days. Crap, you spark the grill and all that.
Lobster tail, the whole nine.
Shit, you know they go over there. They Uncle Twine.
Yeah,
dude, we gotta go home, Uncle Twine. Them lobsters.
Yeah.
What type of butter was that, Uncle
Twan? Twan hooking them up. Twan getting them all that exclusive food.
Right.
No, if the dog's eating boiled chicken,
butter. That's
boiled chicken with gravy and rice and all that shit, yeah, give them the chicken gravy over the rice. And
they got a rice pot for the dogs.
Yeah, no, that.
100 rice pots.
Yeah, tell the kid, don't touch that. That's for the dog.
Real.
Damn. Yeah. That's crazy.
Probably, they ain't even giving the dogs that cheap-ass Uncle Ben shit, either. He got sticky rice. He giving the dogs that eat some rice, $40 bag shit.
Once.
You feed them once a day.
One is 10 and one is 1. So just
you
once.
Only feed them once,
but it's a big ass pan.
Oh, God.
I free feed them, so they eat as much as they want until the next day.
Oh, you got them trained, like,
absolutely. They've been trained since they was puppies.
Do you actually train?
No.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I house train them. I house break them, but I got a trainer that I use that my brother used that do all the other shit.
Shout him out. You know the trainer?
Yeah, Art.
Shout out to Art.
Yeah, man. Yeah, for sure.
Shout out to Art. Wait, he ain't got no company, none of that?
I think that nigga moved to the Dominican Republic.
Oh, Art was a bad motherfucker.
We ain't seen him in
America. I trained a couple
Art
girls.
Art out there talking to he out there training the dogs out there. I better get him a Dominican tennis for Dominican tennis.
Hey, listen. I had trained a couple dogs myself.
You in the Dominican Republic, you talk to the dogs in Dominican, right?
Yeah, you ain't gonna talk to me. Sure. I had trained a couple dogs myself. I just had some snacks and, you know, sit, boo-boo, sit. You know, like the commercial. Gave him a snack. You know, that shit ain't worked for too long.
He was in charge of the prison puppy program and shit.
Nah, I wasn't there.
Man, they stupid as hell.
No, they did. They had dogs in jail.
I know about that for real, but you crazy to say that.
He was in charge of that.
What, for real? I was in charge of that.
No,
I wasn't fucking in charge. He wasn't in charge of that shit.
He ran the prison puppy program.
I wasn't in charge.
He walked around with a state jump on with Wolf on the back.
I just thought it was crazy. When they first brought the dogs in, I was like, damn. They like motherfuckers that, like, you know, they be dogs that, you know, all type of shit would have. They like motherfuckers that had dogs in the cell. It was like they doing, it's like you locking the dog up.
Poor dog.
You say you
lock
the dog up.
No. Well, that dog does get a lot of attention because they ain't got, you know, you in jail.
Yeah. But damn, you think they'd rather be, just if you was a dog, would you rather be in jail or on the streets?
Well, I put it to you like this. Either if you're not in jail with the prisoners, you're going to be in jail at home when they put your ass in that cage because you're going to go in that cage. You know what I mean?
Most no, they had a cage in their cell. They gave them a cage to put in the cell with them, so they're in prison, and then they got to go in the cage when they go in the cell.
But if they rescues, though, that's they like rescue. Taking them off death row and you put them with somebody because, you know, they be killing them dogs.
But I'm just saying, though, if you a dog, like, do you want to be put in a cell with a nigga for 40 years?
You talking about this?
Like, that's some deep shit.
I don't know if I can trust you, dog. You ain't been around nothing. He sit on the floor like, you keep waking up, poking out, man. What's up with you, man? It's only me and you in here, bro. Like, don't get no more time about animal abuse, man. You know, they giving up. They give you another 40, dog, on the floor. Like, go get another 40. Fucking with me.
Dogs ain't no joke.
Dogs ain't no joke, man. Niggas sitting in the prison cell 40 years, man. Ain't got nothing to do, man. I wouldn't trust that if I was a pit bull.
Pitbull handle. Pitbull can handle himself.
I'll be at the gate. Get me out of here.
Pitbulls can handle themselves, though.
Shit.
A pitbull can handle himself.
You got an aggressive, horny nigga who ain't had that before.
Rassle you down and shit. You funny as shit.
Man, crazy.
Oh, my God. I'm crazy, man.
I'm just saying, man. I just be thinking about some crazy shit. Yeah. Sometimes, you know.
This episode of $1 Million Worth of Game is brought to you by Roman Swipes. Mm. You see how small he is?
Mm-hmm,
they fit in your hand. I'm telling you, imagine using these to get into the big game.
Mm.
You're going into the big game, you open it up, wipe it on.
Oh, women!
You let it dry and you make her fly. I'm talking about Roman Swipes would change your life in a way you can't even imagine.
This how she'd be?
Yes, yes. And right now, when you choose Roman Swipes monthly plan, listen. The first month you get for just $5. When you go to GetRoman.com/game, I'm talking about something. You don't need no prescription, clinically proven. I'm talking about last longer, stay stronger, Roman Swipes. So what are you waiting for? Like, because a lot of you guys, you never getting off the bench.
No.
And if you do, you might just go in there, hold the ball for the kicker and get pulled right out.
To all the little homies, stop waiting till y'all bumping to us to get the Roman Swipes.
Yeah, get them yourself. Line. Get them yourself. Go
anytime
to get
them. Y'all see us. I need some Roman.
I need some.
That Roman turned me awesome, to a grown awesome, man. Yeah,
all that stuff. Like,
ooh, they online, bro.
They online. Go to GetRoman.com.
/game.
What are you waiting for? Roman Swipes. Shout out to my boys, Goody Mob, man.
Oh, yeah, man. Shout out
that cell therapy, man. That shit came out when Creed, Big Gip.
Yes, sir.
Like, it was like, man, when that came out, that shit.
Tell us about it.
Listen, man. It was, you know what's crazy about this shit? This was crazy about it. I'm going to show you something. Because I seen this earlier, and I was like, damn, my brother Saif sent me this earlier. Now think about this. This is some deep. Look what Elon Musk is. Look what they talking about. And you remember cell therapy video?
Yep.
When they had the chips,
yep.
And they was going to the store using the chips, the barcodes and shit.
Right. Yep.
And now they talking about putting chips in people and all this shit. Yes. And all, bro, like, that shit was, cell therapy came out a zillion years ago.
Yeah.
And you know, and it's going, I think it's going to be, and it's to the point where, though, that's how they, and they get rid of the money. You barcode on you a chip. Yeah, that's going to be, like, it's crazy.
Everything.
It's over with.
So that shit is just like, to see a video like that in that time, and then now everything is chipped out. Your car got a chip in it. Your door got a chip in it. Your camera got a chip in it. Everything is, we walk around with chips on us all day.
They chipping humans?
Yeah, they chipping them motherfuckers.
They talking about next year, too. I'm like, chip your ass and make your ass go rob a bank.
Yep, chip you and just have you on some dumb shit. Controlling your brain. That shit attached to your brain.
Yeah, fuck all that.
Yeah, how they gonna put a chip in your nugget, man?
If they can chip you, they gonna find out the way to keep you here forever.
But I'm gonna keep it up. They chip me, I'm gonna know.
How you gonna know?
Because I'm gonna have that scar on my biscuit. You can't get through this biscuit without the nugget.
Oh, yeah. What happened? Yeah, you right.
We gonna know, Sleepy.
We gonna know. All of us got you, all of us got they got you, Sleepy. Done.
They chipped you up.
No, see, they might trip Slip up and throw him a new tattoo. He ain't going to see it. He ain't going to be like, damn, I had a tattoo. I was drunk last night. I got a tattoo. He don't know they got a chip in him. Right. He don't even know the words of the song no more.
But I forgot everything.
Just the technology, man, that's out here, man. This shit is unbelievable, man.
Yeah.
Like, this shit, like, bro, they got an app. And this was years ago. That you could download the app and I could call you from any fucking phone number that I want to pop up on your phone. So say if like prime example. So when we got the app, we used to fuck with niggas. So we know somebody that's close to him. Say I know his woman, I got her number, right? I can call him from my phone.
And her number pop up.
Make his woman number pop up and he gonna pick up and say, yeah, what's up, babe? And I could be like, fuck all that, nigga. She done with that shit, nigga. I'm here dicking her down right now. The first thing the nigga's going to do is look at his phone like, to make sure it's her. Like,
that's crazy. Oh, that's crazy.
Bro, we was calling niggas fucking with him, bro. And then got called nigga back. No, no, we just playing, dog.
Don't kill it. Don't kill it. Don't
stop playing, man. I'm on the fucking phone with my woman, man. Because you call your woman back. Who the fuck just called me on the phone? She's sitting there like, what the fuck are you talking about? I'm cooking. So the technology that's out here, that shit's unbelievable, man.
I feel like every app is to destroy a relationship.
Yes, it is.
I feel like it is.
Damn, that's deep.
Talk about it.
It tells on everybody. Everything you have on your phone tells on you.
Yeah.
Period. I don't care what it is. They had one app that was a calculator that you could hide pictures. Ooh,
shit. They got what?
It was. They had an app where it was. It pretended to be a calculator.
The phone. The mic. You want, sleep. And it the mic sleep. Up to put Sleep, you done. You can't perform no more, man. You ain't even on the mic no more. He can't even perform. Don't take him on tour.
Let me put it there and look, man.
Don't take him on tour no more.
They got an app that it's a calculator, and you can put your code in, and it pops up, and you can put pictures that you don't want nobody else to see.
What's the name of the app?
I have no idea.
Oh, I was going to go punch it in my woman's phone. Fuck you doing with this app?
What
pictures you got in here?
Yeah. Fuck is going on?
But the technology, man. Is the shit is unbelievable, man.
Yes, it is.
Like, so, fellas, man, you're going to get caught.
You're going to get caught, bro.
Yes.
It's designed to get caught.
I mean, if
it's
you don't love your woman, you don't give a fuck, then that's...
Yeah, well.
But if you love your woman, man, the reality of it is if she want to catch you, man, she going to catch. Like, prime example, if when I get in one of my cars, every single time I pull up and park, some shit pops up on my phone, says parking location. And I'm like, I never punched that the fuck in. What the fuck did you do when I was asleep?
Mm-hmm. Oh, you gotta watch that. That's, they're putting them things, the air tags on the car now.
I know too, got a GPS tracking system on this motherfucker. Because every fucking time I park, my shit say, you've parked at such and such. I'm like, I never did that. What the fuck is going on?
That's a new little scam out here where they got these little air tags. They put them on your car.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no, that shit. In Philly, them niggas.
Folly. I just seen that.
That ain't new, big boy. They been doing that shit forever.
They been doing it forever.
Shit. Absolutely. Every time I come up out of somewhere, I'm on the ground.
No, but they got small drones now.
Damn. I'm looking up under my shit like this.
Yeah. You got sophisticated criminals out here, man.
Well, I'm telling you.
For real, man. And then this the time, right now.
Yep. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Right now is the time where all the crime is going down. Listen, put some protection on your family because there's a bunch of niggas that's running around here that's willing to do whatever they got to do to get their bitch that Chanel bag for Christmas.
Oh, man. Y'all right across the street from it, too. That Lenny Square right there.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And let me tell you something. These niggas is pulling off all types of moves, all types of home invasions, all types of robberies, all types of back doors is going down. All types of weed setups. If you bring a nigga been buying 2 pounds off you his whole life.
I need
now
you
talk about bring through 20. My man from out of town, he came through. He got the money. All right. Just no nigga.
Even the puppies. You got to be on point, big boy. Yeah, I need about 15 puppies.
And he talk about bring it to the bluff.
Yeah.
Shit. Is the bluff still in operation, though? I only know the bluff from that motherfucking that movie.
Yeah, that motherfucker's still in operation, bro. Yeah, all this shit's bunking right now. Yeah, this shit right. Crimin' time, like you
crimin
said.
Crimin' time. It's the month of Robin. What are you talking about? Look at California. California is really going crazy.
They going crazy. Because,
and the reality of it is all this shit only going up by one thing. Some pussy.
Yep. Got to get them gifts together for girly.
Yep. So, all this shit. Women, do you realize how strong y'all are out here?
Stronger than the motherfucker.
That the closer it get to Christmas, the more dangerous niggas get.
Niggas get dangerous.
They don't get that fucking, what? Do you know what type of shit's going to be going down on the 23rd? Because now nigga got to risk it all about that motherfucking Chanel bag. He only got one motherfucking day left.
That's crazy to think about that shit.
That's crazy when you think about it because the reality of it is that's really what's happening. Every year around this time, it be the most robberies, the most break-ins, the most niggas getting burnt, the most because a nigga is trying to hustle some money up.
Think buy about some gifts for
hustle some money up to go fuck all of it up.
Yep.
Just for one moment.
for that coochie.
So if you got a woman who you got to put your motherfucking life at jeopardy for some Christmas gifts, she ain't the right bitch. I'm just keeping it real with
Reach.
You. She ain't the right one for you.
Yeah.
You niggas, or you got your woman in the wrong way, nigga. You ain't caught her, you bought her.
That's what it
yeah.
is.
Yeah.
You were fronting. You was fronting shit, and she thought you had it like that.
Right.
So now you got to go out here and rob niggas just to go show her that you kind of do have it like that, but you don't.
Right.
Yeah, that's real.
Right. All because you put up a facade, a front of you a nigga who you really ain't.
That sound like a rest haven for hoes.
No, you got a lot of motherfuckers.
That's a rest haven for hoes.
That's what it is.
And you know what's crazy down here? It's going crazy because a lot of motherfuckers trying to go to the strip club with gifts. They trying to take their favorite stripper a gift. Oh, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yo.
Word. Think about that. What?
Yeah, the game. They say the game changed. That's
the game. Hey, man, the young brothers out here, man, they have completely changed the game as far as money with women. Like back in my day, you could pay a phone bill, you could pay a house, you know, little rent, give them like $400-500. You good. Now, $10,000, $20,000.
You got to buy the bitch a Bentley, a Phantom.
You got to get it up.
He said, you fucked the game. He said, he fucked the game.
He fucked the game completely like, up, young one.
Like, you know, we get a bitch a car. We get a bitch a car back in the G. You young nigga, bitch, you get right behind the bitch. You getting an Acura.
Not now.
A new joint, bitch. You get a new Acura, bitch. You ain't getting, bitch. Imagine me a nigga gift wrapping a 600. Bitch, you wasn't with me shooting in the gym.
Hey, man.
Fuck with me. When Dre walked in with the motherfucker, the shoulder pads on.
He wasn't around.
He had the white hair, bitch. You wasn't there putting the bars down with us.
Fuck in that studio.
A Bentley.
Yeah.
But the shit that the pedestal that women be putting niggas on and niggas be competing with niggas who ain't even living a real life relationship. Yeah. If you live in a real life relationship, she wouldn't even want no Bentley and no motherfucker that little ass bit of time y'all been together. She would have been like, no, I want the other B, a business.
It is.
That's the other B.
You got bitches out here got Bentleys and no business.
None.
That's crazy. No, they coochie is their business.
No.
Coochie LLC.
Yeah, you right. They selling that book because the nigga buy you a Bentley. This niggas out here. This niggas out here buying Phantoms and shit. Motherfucking the money. Go ahead, get them tired of you riding that. Nigga, you only been with her for 30 days. Nigga, fuck you mean you tired of riding that.
That's what I'm saying.
Let her drive some of your shit. For you go lace her. For you go fuck her $400,000. And then, because I'm a type of nigga, if I buy a woman something, I ain't never taking it back. That's just, I'm going to stand on that because if I bought it for you, it's because I wanted you to have it.
Yep.
And that was solely the reason. And if I bought it for you, it's because you deserved it.
Hey, absolutely. Yeah.
You put enough motherfucking tick, enough time in to deserve a Bentley.
Preach.
Yeah.
But shit, I ain't never taking it back. That's a flaw in my character. That's just how I was raised. I'm an old school nigga. I ain't never been no Indian giver.
Yeah.
But if you do shit too early in the game, then you feel obligated.
Yeah.
You catch it with a goddamn dick in the mouth. I'm coming to get them keys, bitch. Bitch, you think I'm sweet, bitch.
Come get them keys.
Bitch, I'm coming to get them keys now, bitch. You said it was my Bentley, bitch, is in my name.
Right.
It was to that piece hit your mouth.
Right.
Damn.
It was to rah rah pistol whip you, bitch.
Oh shit.
Oh man.
So man, don't when you choosing your woman, man, choose her wisely, man.
And take your time.
Right. Stop trying to force it on her, man. Stop trying to put her in a predicament. A lot of you niggas get your women and then you put her in a predicament where she can't leave.
Yeah.
You move into a goddamn 8,000 foot square house and the money's hard for her to fucking leave when she was just in that low ass studio fucking apartment in Buckhead.
She's not leaving.
When she was just in motherfucking zone 3.
And you know they got all these laws, but they don't gotta leave.
No, that common law wife, stay long enough.
Motherfucker, like, I want you out of my crib, bitch, you getting out, police come. Oh no, she ain't leaving, it's her house, just as yours.
That's 5 years in L.A. That's 5 years.
Wait, hold on. Wait, say that shit again.
That's 5 years. 5 years in L.A. If your woman stays with you over 5 years, live with you, that's basically y'all married.
Oh, no, you is shit. That's the law. If I was single, I met a chick, we had to do little increments like, bitch, you're going to stay for three. Then you're going to live at your house for a year, bitch. We're going to break this up. But this five consecutive years, right? Now, bitch, I'm going to move you next door. Yeah, all right, bitch, you're going to live in the guest house. Is the guest house considered my shit?
you got to have a lawyer that's on anything.
Fuck that, man. Like, imagine you got a girlfriend, y'all been together for 5 years, and now she do some shit and she ain't got to leave. Nigga, what? That's the type of shit you go to jail. You be out there fucking fighting the police. The fuck out of here. Get the fuck up out of here. No. You,
like, sorry, sir. She got a light bill in her name.
Right. Fuck, like, that shit crazy. Like that. That's crazy, man. But listen, the album is out.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
The big sleepover.
The big sleepover.
Yeah.
The big fucking sleepover.
It's going down.
Did y'all have fun recording it?
So much fun, bro. It was really easy. It was relaxed because we worked so, you know, for so many years together. And me and Big Boy always had a sort of thing where, like, every time we did a record together, it was special. You know, from So Fresh, So Clean, The Way You Move, West Savannah, just everything we've done, Bowtie, all kind of songs. So it was really kind of simple and easy to work together because we're so used to it.
Question to both of y'all. What, I know y'all don't really like to do this, but what's your favorite song on the album?
Today.
He said today. That shit changed.
Baller.
Yeah.
Tomorrow might be something different.
But Baller, yeah.
It's Baller.
Yeah.
For me, it's Do Your Best For Me because it's such a pimp record.
Okay, see, look, you know he back.
He still thinking.
When he threw that out there, when he said,
"Get that shit up,
he said, man."
He
said, "Went 400 or 500."
Sleep still got his hand in the game.
That's why he said the young brothers fucked the game up.
I take you from the frozen lakes to the Golden Gates, bitch.
I give a. He told him, "Bitch, I give a pig a wig and give her a gig." You know what I'm saying? You understand? Either you gonna hold up or blow up, make your next move, your best move. He told me the young brothers fucked the game. I used to be able to give him 400 or 500, and it was cool.
It was cool, man. It was so cool.
He pissed about that shit.
It was so cool, baby.
Sleepy used to be a fucking pimp before he was let nobody know.
Mackin' and Decatur, Volume 1.
Mackin' and Decatur. Wow, boy, man.
Yeah, man.
But listen, man, make sure y'all go listen to that motherfucking album.
The Big Sleepover.
Stream it.
Yeah.
Yes.
You know, do your motherfucking TikToks to it.
All that
yes,
shit.
Yes, please do.
Do your Instagram videos to it. Repost. Show these legends some love out here.
Yeah,
and I'm just we just saying go listen to some good music because these niggas don't need it. Yes. I'm just keeping it real. They did this shit for you.
They don't need it.
Yeah. They did it for you.
Yeah, man.
Nigga got 7,500 shows a year, nigga.
Yeah, 7,500.
So go enjoy the good music, the great vibes, the good experience, man.
Y'all boys keep doing what y'all doing.
Yeah, man.
Hey, man.
Y'all man, we really appreciate like you legends for pulling up. You know we don't interview too many old niggas. We ain't really in it.
Well, we appreciate it.
We interview legends.
Legends.
Yeah, I mean, bunch of you old niggas call. Yeah, I want to get on.
Y'all niggas crazy.
Like, no, I'm just playing. Man. No, stupid. But just real talk. We base our motherfucking platform around the niggas that own tomorrow.
Yeah.
The future. You feel what I'm saying? But we also interview the legends that can come here and can inspire the youth.
Yeah. Right.
The legends that the young niggas still care about. The legends that they could give you some game that could uplift you because we ain't got to question what your value is. We know what your value is.
Right.
The trendsetters, the niggas who made a young thug wanna rap, right. You made a young T.I. wanna rap. We commend y'all brothers. Appreciate because y'all opened up the doors for a city who was basically needing it.
Yeah.
Needing that lift.
Yeah.
And I know y'all don't run around and poke y'all chest out and say we did that. So I'm gonna poke y'all chest out for y'all. Y'all did that.
Yes.
And the one thing I respect about all the Atlanta artists, every fucking artist we interviewed, they all gave it up to y'all.
Yeah.
I salute them niggas for that, for not forgetting who really them niggas, who really opened the doors, who really the reason why I'm here. Without Dr. J, it ain't no motherfucking nobody for Michael Jordan to look up to and say, I want to jump from the motherfucking foul line.
Yeah. Tell it, bro.
Without no motherfucking Michael Jordan, it ain't no Kobe Bryant to look up to say, I want to walk like that.
Right.
I wanna do a fadeaway jumper like that.
Is you gonna
that.
Say without no Kobe, it ain't no LeBron to look up to?
No, I'm gonna say without no me, it ain't no you, nigga.
Oh, shit.
I used to put this nigga in the tub and wash him up when he used to shit in the tub all the time as a baby and shit. You know what I mean? I
got to handle
that.
That's
lying,
man.
Y'all nigga, wow. I
love y'all, nigga, lying to me, sleep. Get out of here, man.
My favorite shit is like every time I see a video, get like he start like this.
This nigga, hold on. He saw you. This nigga here, he be crying. This nigga said, "Why? I know it's
because
be so
he did. He went to jail at 17, you know, and he did 20 years. And it's a lot of shit he just don't know, man. And he asks a lot of dumbass questions.
No, I don't ask. I'm be doing research out here. Fuck this man.
Some of that shit, some of that shit be like, "Cuz, you just ask me that? Like,
I be doing research.
Serious? Like, I ain't even gonna put some of the shit you ask. You know what I mean? I ain't gonna put that
whatever
shit out there."
Locked up at 17, bro, and come out stronger than ever and killing the game, man. Much respect, bro.
Appreciate that, bro.
That's a strong brother, man.
Appreciate that, man.
Keep doing your thing. Yeah.
Doing your thing.
Keep holding each other down like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, keep holding each other down.
You got to.
Y'all do like us, bro.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's how it got to be, man. Yep. And before we get out of here and we wrap this interview up, man, the realest shit that was said on this interview today was that, and they didn't even say it through words, they said it through a different way, is that our friendship was greater than money.
Period.
He told the story how he signed to this man. This man probably made a shitload of money off of this man. But then he got to a point and said, run with it, nigga.
Yep.
Made sure his shit was
and guess what? Ain't no grudges being held. Mm-hmm. Ain't no everybody mama fed.
Yep.
Everybody family eating. So they didn't choose money over friendship, man. Them niggas chose that we got money, man. We already living way better than we was living. So we already made it the fuck out. Stop letting money come in between relationships, man, if you really fuck with that person.
Yeah.
Me and this nigga ain't gonna never fall out about no motherfucking money. Ever. You ain't never got to worry about, oh, what's him getting out of there? Then niggas got money. And like, how could we ever do that?
Unless Johnson & Johnson cutting that check.
No, I'm gonna get Jergens to hook him up.
No, they're gonna slap me in the head with a gun and send him a statement. You know what I mean? That's all.
That ain't one pistol with
yeah, that's all. Because I know you can't go get the pistol back. You too scared to go back to jail. So, right? You know, I mean? So you know when you got to up on a nigga. He'll parole to 2048. He'll want to chase that shit. We is walking across the street to the Mario's. He's talking about, do the light red. And I'm like, nigga, what? I ain't walk across the motherfucking street to light red, nigga. Fuck that.
Oh, man.
So I got to up on him. You get that Johnson & Johnson money, don't tell me.
Hit me all in my biscuit.
One of them joints where you slap him and it hurts so bad, don't nothing come out when his mouth open up.
Yeah. All that dumb shit.
Man, it's stupid. Oh, my God. Tears, boy.
But, man, wow. I appreciate y'all brothers for coming through, man.
Appreciate you, bro.
Once again, go get the album, download it, stream it, enjoy it. Great vibes, man. Big boy, Sleepy, man.
Yep.
And it's just like that.
Right.